I'm Dr. Sreenivas Murthy TM. So most often parents would have taken the children to their pediatricians, and the pediatricians with the symptom of say cold, my child is having cold. So basically it would mean running nose, sniffing, and then having some difficulty in breathing. And the pediatrician would treat it accordingly based on whether it is a acute problem or a chronic problem. Now most acute problems are self-limiting problems. Now we need to understand both the words, acute and self-limiting. Acute is anything which has happened in a very short duration of time. It has happened over a past few days to maybe a week or so. And self-limiting, that means whether we intervene, we don't intervene, whether the body is able to fight it off, that is called self-limiting. Now most acute infections are self-limiting, but at the same time in today's world, because nobody wants to have sick absenteeism, we will need to give medication so that the child will feel comfortable. Hence some medication to that extent will be given in the form of fever control, running nose control, decongestants, saline drops, and these are the usual things. Now, when does a pediatrician consider the possibility of adenoids being a cause? When the child tends to have a constant cold despite giving all this medication. Now, then how do we confirm whether the child has adenoids or not? So, most often, because the adenoid is at the back of the nose, in very young children, say at the age of 2 or 3, it would be difficult to do any outpatient-based procedures to confirm the diagnosis. In a slightly older child of around 7 or 8 years, we will be able to confirm the same by doing a simple outpatient procedure called nasal endoscopy, in which we will be able to identify the size of the adenoids. Whereas in very small children, what we rely upon is an X-ray, a simple X-ray of the nasopharynx, that means the back of the nose from the side view, it is called lateral view. We will be able to identify the size of the adenoids. Now, when somebody has adenoidal hypertrophy, the first thing that doctor would do is give saline sprays. We get saline sprays in mist form for younger kids so that they can tolerate the nose being cleansed with saline. And after the cleansing is happened, then we will give a very mild dose of steroidal nasal sprays, which will tend to reduce the size of the adenoid. Now steroids, the moment we use the word steroid, many parents get apprehensive and worried. But these steroids are made for action in the nasal cavity. It will not get absorbed into the body. It will not have other effects on the body. Can safely be given for as long as about 2 months every day. So when we give this for this long duration, we have seen a majority of patients or the children responding well to the medication, and the size of the adenoid actually reduces and they become symptom free. But the catchword is that we need to give it for a long duration, for as long as a month or more.